Welcome back then, this is part 9. Like, after we did the Black Slater and then I saved it, I quit the header. You need to quit the header now for this last part, and then we need to start it back up, so click the header back up. Let's put the body cam over this, and then you press load. Loading port lodge. This is going to be exporting the whole course. Press F1. Since the last time I put Vamos over there and Vamos up there, so just seeing from course site. So something in the background. Right, press F2 to keep stuff. Now, point to point, you got export and fast export. You just want to click export. Now I'm going to click this, and you'll see this will go off like it did with the building lights. And then I'm going to pause and let the export happen. It takes about 5 minutes, so it's pointless to me gabbling on for 5 minutes while it's doing this. So I click export. Now it's going to take a while to do this, so I'm going to stop recording till it's done and we'll come back till when it's done. Now it's come back on. I was talking about 3 minutes, so I'll save this and we will quit it and we'll export the all folder into the game. So if this to save them, you know, we'll quit this editor now, then click the Bandicam on the full screen. Put this on full screen. There we go. We clicked about this editor. Now we need to put the course in the 3D folder. So I'll click PC desktop. Go into my point to point course folder. Read goes and it is top large. You see in the like the crowd data, whale, shadows, terrain, trees, backup and the map. And this is the overlay. So what I'll do, I'll right click on copy, go back into the PC local C drive program files, back into Status Order 6 3D courses, into the courses, and I'll just right click and I'll paste this course into it, and there it goes. Now the course is now in the game, but of course you haven't put the course in the course data file. I'll show you where that goes. You go in your data folder. I'm using this UK course, so I'm going to folder 1. And you go into the course at that, and this is where you keep where your courses are. As you can see, the Ascot on top is a right, and the track, and I highlighted the location. That's going to be very important for you to put. You need that to put it onto the map. I'll show you to get that in a minute. So I know this is jumps 1, so I'll go down to jumps 1, here it is. I'm going to take out, I'm going to baking them would be a good choice for this. Look at baking them, I like it, copy it, because it's a left hand course as well, so I'm going to copy that, The open node part. Open another version of Notepad. There we go. Click faking them in. I'm going to take faking them out. I'm going to type in hope large. Notice it in a different location to fake them, so I've got to delete that. I'm going to analyze that a minute. I need to find the location, and you do that by opening up your Google Maps, and you know that's the course there, so we pan out. That gives you the idea where on the world map Hope Lodge is in the Midlands, Nottingham. In Nottingham, Leicester, not far away, so we know it's where it is. Now we're going to have to find the location on the world map in your game, so memorize that. I'll get rid of this course start at the moment. Now we go back up, we go down to the GFX folder. Click on that, go down to the world folder, and on world, right at the bottom, right outside 4096, right click that and you open it with paint. Now if you notice down in the left hand corner here, as I move this mouse, you see the numbers changing. That's your location identifier. So we move over to where the UK is. So yeah, I'm pointing the point on near enough the Midlands. I'm noting down there in the left hand corner, it says 1751145. So I was normally have my notepad close to me, and I would write down 1751145, a little comma in the middle there. Now we can close this map. We go back up into my notepad. I add it, and I'll type in there 1751145. That will be the location of the map. Of course, I will edit it, copy back into my game. I will go back out, go back up, go back into the data, back into folder one, back into course start. I will then scroll down back into the jumps tag, and scroll for a pack, so it's a T, so I'll try to put in up with your bet your order, and I will go between Stratford Weatherby, so make a little gap. Now I will right click and paste Hope Lodge now, and I'll fire up and save. Now it's in the game, we can see if this course actually works. I'll not save that. So normally you would have a couple of races on the schedule and showcase the point, but we can use the base kit for this layout handy just to see if it does work. I have a couple of horses already in the thing, so and see test the coast course, sorry, not coast, course, and see if it's in there. There's a couple of runners there, so click on the course and we go down. Hope Lodge is in there, there it is. As You come out, it comes up just when it says Nebigas, because we only put the one course on. So we're going to have a nice fine day on good ground. We'll make it grade one. It's going to be 2 or 4 mile. And because it's fences and all that, leave everything else up, we put five of that. And we'll select the runners, there's your ball. And then we'll save and view race, and we're going to see if this course works. Loading in. There's the course, 2 mile four, chase, foot blood. Up. Horses don't want for the whales, but if they do, we just slightly move the waypoints and do this. Start again, seeing everything seems to be fine. There's no jolting, except the lap point up here. Let me tell on the second circuit. Right, so we're 12 on 6 here. Let's start the race. And this is what the course looks like. We've just built together. Up across the low end. Not liking that big mountain they built. This is a bit big, but it happens. Even was making smaller. Right. Seems to be going okay at the moment. Nah, mountain's not right. Oh, I'll leave it that way then. It's okay. Check it. So we'll select from the stand, and that's where the camera was. We put him. F2 go back to the runners. If you press F1 on your keyboard and just move your mouse, you can glide, let's say. You can move around, of course, with the horses are running around. That's F1 on the mouse. You can do that in the game anyway. That's F2. It goes back to what it was before. Come to the ditch. The ditch looks fine. So, the course is working. So, everything looks good. So, that's how you build your course. Water looks good over there. The only problem I really have is that mountain, but I'll leave it in there. First one we built is pretty big, isn't it? Fences are pretty big. We can alter them. You can do that yourselves. Oh. So this is the course we built. As you see, the horse is not going for the whales. The horse is not taking the bad path. I just make sure there's no jolting. The next time we're only coming for a lap. I think it's fine. I suppose. Cheering crowd. So that's it for you then. So we've completed the building the course together. I hope you have fun trying. It gets easier as you do it more often. Hope it helps somebody, people out as well. For Scott and Doug, all you need to do at Flemington really is to move the waypoint, the 5 foot starts, move it back, use the numpad to get the 6 foot marker up, and once you've got the 6 foot marker up, you just move the trees yourself, like I did, and clip the wheels, move the wheels back, and you should be able to have a 6-1 straight for this. I'll flip this up. Clever. Finish this race though. So that's it. I'm gonna load in Flemington for Doug, and it's a big course, Flemington. Just to show what I did on it. I didn't have to hold anything apart from a waypoint, a few fences, wheels, and that's it really. I've got the trees a bit moved. Getting it. What number is number 3, isn't it? So I need to get it up. Sorry for that. What I did, boys, is went up here. You see how back the W waypoint number 1 is. What I did is I clicked on Turf 1, which is already on, and then I clicked the furlough mark is here, 8 and 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4. That was where the 5 furlows ties. What I did was I stretched these waypoints back, the first two, but you see the big capture 1 and 2. Once I knew 6, clicked 8 again, was up there. What I did was move some trees, click the wheel, move the wheels up by just moving the green balls and making a wrap around, saving it, and then exported it. And it should work fine in your game. So that's it then. Hope you enjoyed this. Learning to build a race course. Hope you try now. And let me know how you get on. Thank you.